In this video, we're going to look at receiving payment on an invoice as a record transfer or record transfer. As usual, we'll come look at our invoices. You see several are paid now. An invoice, receive payments. As I told you, do not use receive a payment. That is old function. They just haven't removed it from the UI yet. Go to receive payments, new. Click on that. Click add. Choose your bank or undeposited funds. We'll choose our bank account here. We'll choose record transfer, customer. If you don't know who it is off the top of your head, I mean, if you don't see it in the list, you can just start typing in the name. We'll do it with Fullerton. The date will be based on today's current date. You can change it if you need to. It will affect how it posts, but it won't hurt anything when you're doing it here. So be sure you have the correct date in there for both receipt and payment date. You can put in reference number, payment menu. You can also, as usual, in most all screens, data entry screens, you can add an attachment if you want to, which is going to be like the backup document, maybe the check for credit cards, maybe the credit card receipt. For record transfer, it would maybe be the bank statement, whatever backup document you can get for it. We'll look here. Let's say we drafted Fullerton Lumber for $170,000. Add and close. So now we know that the amount received was, we have to put this in up here. If we do not, it'll give us a big old error and not let us post. Come here. Let's do a reference number. Let's just say we drafted it from their account. Come over here. We'll do post. And it processed. We see EFT because that was a draft. Over here, as I told you, in AR, it will automatically drop you to posted payments. See, same screen. Again, you can come over here to registers and look at receipts. You can go to your AR, you can go to your cash management bank register, and you'll see the transaction within there.